Bank of Uganda took a step to liquidate and revoke the license of EFC Uganda Limited on 19th January 2023. The move was attributed to the institution's failure to resolve its significance under capitalization and poor corporate governance. Since then, the government, through its body, the Deposit Protection Fund of Uganda, has embarked on payment of all the depositors who are keeping their money in this microfinance. In a news conference today held in Kampala, they have confirmed clearing 50% of the depositors who held balances of up to 10 million shillings. All depositors with balances below 100,000 shillings who submitted valid national identification numbers and matching mobile phone details have also been paid.
Effective today, February 12, 2024, the fund has made arrangements to start receiving and verifying documents of depositors who held company and joint accounts.
Depositors have, however, been tasked to provide some documents before they are worked on, including a letter confirming the account name in EFC Uganda Limited and the names and the signatures of the signatories to the accounts, a registered board resolution indicating the bank account to which the deposit should be paid, certificate of incorporation and location of the company, memorandum and articles of the association, copies of the valid national identification cards of the signatories.
PPF further urges individual account holders who have not yet received their protected deposits of up to 10 million shillings to present their valid original national identification cards to the DPF staff stationed at Stanbic Bank, Lugogo branch, during working hours.
Depositors with a mismatch in the NINs and telephone numbers have been advised to correct the mess so that their money is paid. Dr. Julia Olima Oyet.
2019, we have been running a campaign in the media asking all depositors to update their personal information with their respective financial institutions. However, some depositors have not done this, and this has affected the speed at which we are able to pay them. Nevertheless, those who submitted this information were happy that we've been able to serve them fast. So for this exercise to be successful and to be faster, all Ugandans who have bank accounts should update their information accordingly.
They went ahead and highlighted the number of depositors to be paid and those who are found known to be eligible for payment. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.